Welcome to the RN classes. We have discussed the work power and energy. We have almost completed the work power and energy. So we have to completed here 4 chapters. But now we have to give the revisions, that is to be first chapter, and after we have to second and third and fourth. We have to revise. The first chapter we have to revise here, that is to be motion. It means revisions of first chapter. The first chapter simply says that we have to see the motion and how the motion can be analyzed here. If any particle that changes its position with respect to location, and that is called in motion condition. It means it changes its position with respect to time. If suppose a particle is here, at some interval of a time this particle goes here, at some interval of a time these particles meets at another point. It means at the time changes the location of the particle is also changes. If the location is changes, the particle simply says that it is in motion conditions. And if it is in motion condition, it means it moves continuously. It means, what is the definition of the motion? If any particle changes its position with respect to time and space, then it is called motion. Motion means movement. We simply say that motion means movement of the particle. If the movement of particle is continuously done, then we say that this particle is continuously motion. Otherwise, it is not in continuous motion. And we say that if any particle that is in continuously motion, it means that is in motion condition. Otherwise, it is in rest condition. The second definition is that what is the rest? Now, how we can define the rest? We can define in the rest if any particle, any objects that does not changes its locations. If we see this particle at this location at this time, we see this particle again, we have to see if the time is increases, we have again see the particle at this location. And after that, we have to see the again the particle in this location. The particles never changes its location. Now, if particle does not changes its position with respect to time, then we simply say that particle is in rest condition. It means its location can be traced here. Any time instant, the particle does not change its location. Every location is to be fixed location, and no changement of the location can be done, and then it is called simply in rest condition. That is the second point we have to observe. It means if any particle does not change its position with respect to time. This is the second definition of motion. Now we have to move further here. We have to simply justify two definitions. What is the rest and what are the motions? And now we have to see, we have to know that there are seven fundamental quantities and exponents. It means seven fundamental quantities. There are seven fundamental quantities that we have to know. The first fundamental quantity is that mass, length, time, electric current, temperature, next luminous intensity, amount of substance. And these fundamental quantities we have to learn here, and what is the unit of this all fundamental quantities. So mass is measured in kg, length measured in meter, time measured in second, electric current measured in ampere, temperature measured in kelvin, luminous intensity is measured in candela, and amount of substance is measured in mole. So we have to remember all these fundamental quantities, the seven fundamental quantities we have to learn with SI units. Because with the starting of the physics, we have to remember these fundamental quantities. If because all of the physics just totally depends on the fundamental quantities, first we learn, after that SI unit, what is the representation of the fundamental quantities, and these fundamental quantities are used in all of the physics. After that we have to derive fundamental quantities, how the derived conditions could be occurred. If we are using the basic fundamental quantities, we have to take the two fundamental quantities and derive the third, that is called the derived quantities, which are totally depends on the derived quantities. It means fundamental quantity, if we are using two fundamental quantities, after next fundamental quantities to be derived, that is called derived quantities.